Hi, my name is Antonio Manyagi. Have you ever tried sweet potato or beetroot chapati, which is enriched with provitamin A? I am a food innovation specialist. My company is Your Ingredients, specialized in cold pressed juices and also enriched with local crops ingredients for the dough, for the bakery industry. And this is my story. My name is Antonio Manyagi. I'm the CEO and co-founder of Your Ingredients. We are specialized in doing the chapati dough, ready to roll and all that. And also we'd also do ready-made chapatis and all that. Myself, actually growing and being in the foster family back in Europe and adopted by Terran parents, I was born here in Kenya. But it happened that I also did, because of my background in terms of the food processing aspect, I was needed to go to Uganda. So I flew in through Kenya. While I was in stopover, I met somebody that they were doing ice cream. And one of the key things I've been doing overseas was that. So I asked, but they were using imported ingredients. So I asked, why are you importing ingredients? So the guy ended up in reporting to the owner. Somebody's questioning too much about our product. So the owner came in and he said, what are you talking? I told him, yes, why are you importing sugar and the rest of the ingredients and yet you have everything here? So he said, are you sure? So I explained what I do. He was interested. He told me, but I told him I was in transit. I have to go to Uganda. So we made an agreement. I go and I come back and help him out. So I was able to cut all their costs by 70%, reducing all their imports by using the local ingredients. As I ended up, word mouth started up, I started supporting somehow some local juice bars as well. And the next thing is, Taskis came up that they needed somebody to develop the bread, but they were referred to somebody from Italy who I have been working with. They said, Dad, there's somebody who can help and is currently in the region, so we talk. So I developed the Taskis bread. And as I developed the Taskis bread, I realized what the challenges most people had is the lack of the know-how in terms of food processing and infusion of the local ingredient. They did not understand the crops as ingredients. To them, they were crops. And that's what is top. You boil, you cook, and all that. But for me, because I understood most of the ingredients that people are using are extracted from this. So we're able to do that. And that's how the journey started. So we started up. The next thing we know, while we're doing the work with Taskis supermarkets, International Potato Sales comes along and say, we need some help in Rwanda to do the cookies with OFSP. We're looking for a machine. So we agreed they needed a machine. We organized for them to ship in the machine from Italy. We went, we did the installation. In Rwanda, as we were waiting, because we had a time limit, I was pushing them, please bring your dough for the cookies so we can move on. But they were not able to do that. So I was struggling. So I told them, can I do a formula for you so I can get you going, so I can get to the airport and fly back? So when I did that, they were surprised you can do that. So I was able to develop. And currently, that is one of the flagship products until now, which is being commercialized by one of the biggest companies in Rwanda. So coming back from Rwanda after I finished that and all that, what we discovered is, as I look around for concept, we target a lot and I go around in the informal sector, because the street people are the most innovative people that I've come across. They're always looking for ideas, but their challenge is how to get this to commercialize and scaling. One thing I discovered, and we were running a juice bar, is one product which we developed was so-called dawa, that is the lemon, ginger, and all that. But most of the people could not be able to do that. And we're looking at, people are buying it because of the vitamin. A lot of people make a mistake of the orange flesh when they hear OFSP or orange flesh sweet potato. It's actually not the skin, because you can get different types of skin color, but inside is what matters. If it's orange, it contains provitamin A, which is the most important. So we figured out how to extract that and infuse into the dawa, and also we have a juice as well to blend. It contains more provitamin A than actually carrot. Carrot contains more water, a lot of it, but less, while the sweet potato, the orange flesh sweet potato, contain a lot more. We currently have a range for the bakery through Chapati King. We have different types of, we have the dough ready to roll, and also we have as well ready-made chapati. On the chapati aspect, we have three types. We have the standard wheat, but we focus a lot on the low GI, that is low glycemic index, that is the blend of the sweet potato and all that. But also we have a variety in that. We have beetroot, we have green leaves, dry cereals, fresh cereals, green grams, all that we have. But also the dough, but we also have chapati as well, which is ready to eat, just warming. If you need, you can call us. So we're targeting, if you're supplying schools and all that, you can talk to us, we can be able to do. We also have juices, cold press. We don't do pasteurization on that. So we only do cold press to retain the nutrients as well. And we are processing fruits every day. So we have developed hot and cold beverages out of the agro-processing. So we look at beetroot, we look at the roots and tube and all that. We look at the plantain, we look at the bananas. So anything that is biofortified, we are key. And since we have figured out all the technology behind it, so we are focused in anything where we can get and we can extract. And our model is source, if we can, 100% local. The sourcing of the raw materials which come across in Kenya from all the regions, because the seasonality and all that, but also across the region, that is from Tanzania, Uganda, Rwanda. We also get products as well as far as DRC. The biggest challenge which we realize, most of the products which goes to the market, people want perfectly shaped or really look nice looking. The rest of the products are not being used. So we are giving people opportunity that we can actually utilize, because as we're not looking for a regular shape, we can work with any shape or crop, because as we're interested in the content. So what do we do when we receive all the raw materials? One of the key things, we follow our safety protocols, which we have a HACCP. So we have to inspect and batch and everybody. So from the vehicle, which if we get it from the market, we track down, we get the supplier to actually provide us the details and the source and the vendor who is coming in, and we get the region. So we can do a traceability back if we need. I know it's a challenge, but because of able to identify and looking up, because the cost of doing certification or GAP, which is the certification protocol for farmers and growers, not everybody can do, small farmers can afford it. But what we do with the aggregators, we get the region where we do, and that's how we track back to which region the product come from. And we can also anticipate and planning and the seasonality, because a lot of people are using the rain to be able to work on the crop. So you can be experienced GAP. So what we did is we installed a walk-in freezer, which can be able to hold up to 16 tons of our frozen products. So we process it, we freeze it, so that we can cover the gaps that we have for a month or two while we wait for the other season. But also the other challenge is, what people are doing is they tend to undercut and all that. So by the time they're getting to us, the product has stayed for too long to be able to look at. So we're looking, and we encourage anyone that has any platform or anything, and he has direct farmers, they can contact, because now we're getting calls. That's how we're trying to advertise and tell anyone, whoever has a crop. Like now, we have given contracts to resolve this. We have a contract farmer in Embu, who grows this orange sweet potato for us, and is also gonna grow as well the new variety of the purple flesh, which is being released. We also work with the CAFIS in terms of, we tell them, whoever they give us the planting materials and all that, all this organization, we are here to process, because us, our expertise are processing, and that's what to add value on that. So they're helping us to tackle that, although it's slowly coming up. So hopefully, as we go on and we grow our capacity and everything we're doing, we should be able to streamline. But we rely a lot on aggregators, because we cannot focus on going to get it, so we have to send people, and they also need to make sure they have enough load to be able to bring. So those are the challenges and all that. So people working out there, they can help, because that is one of the biggest challenge. You have either too many crops grown all at once, so you have too much glut, and we can get, and then all of a sudden you have nothing. That is now where the challenge is coming. But we are solving that challenge, because like for the period which we use, we are working a solution, what we call hot fill system, so that we can be able to store the sweet potato puree for without refrigeration for a period of 6 to 12 months. And we are actually underway, and we're able to do. We have already successfully doing for 3 months, but we're looking now to extend the shelf life all the way without using preservatives. And that, because one of the key thing is, we are going away as a clean label, and that the reason why we look at the local ingredients and local crop as ingredients to use in our facility. One of the interesting part about innovation, a lot of people, and I've seen many people here, especially the millennium, where we have the challenge, they're trying to get into the IT developing apps, but they should look the actual innovations are happening. These are street people, solve the gap. They's already told you what they need, but they're struggling. You can come in and close the gap. And we take, we drive almost on a weekly basis. We'll go to every corner we can get. We'll drive, we'll stop. We talk to the people in the street. Just ask, what is the challenges they're going? But that is the one key thing. But our most important thing, please, whatever you take up, you need to focus on that. Forget everything else. You cannot be working, having a job and use this one as a side hustle. Forget it, it's not gonna work. Because that is the challenge we have. Because as you're doing that, the other person you're hiring is also doing the same. So you're not gonna get 100%. So it's important from my experience and all that, is you need to focus and you need to know your business. You not necessarily need to have an understanding of how to do everything, but you need to know what is involved. And take time. Nothing happens, nobody graduates from high school in a day. With your ingredients, we are looking to be the leaders, particularly in African context, in terms of providing our products, in terms to be able to have as a franchise. We realize we can be able to do a franchise model and distribution model across the region, because you can't do this alone. So you need to recruit the people and all that. So we are looking more to work. The region currently, our target is to be able to dominate the Eastern Central Africa from Ethiopia and all that. I've been working with Injera. I've been able to develop a similar concept, but with Injera. And because of the cost of TAFE and all that going up, we're looking at those. So we are getting partners who are interested in our model, and we're looking that to recruit. So we want to be able to be one of the best innovation company in food, and to continue innovate in terms of equipment, delivery system, but also using and encouraging everyone to use what is grown locally. Because all what you need, it's available here, in regardless of whatever you do. Because most of the product goes outside, they're reprocessed, they're sent back. And yet you have everything on your back here. So to me, that is, I want to be able to see your ingredients, Chapati King, and the affiliated business franchises that we're developing, being the dominant in that, and to be able to get everybody else, that whoever is doing farming, that it's viable. There's a channel and there's a place. And we want to tell people, specialize. Farming makes money, also don't give up. But because if you can partner with us, we're able to be able to grow you. Because the other thing is, we look at security of supply. So we want to have people who can guarantee the supply, and we want to grow. And that's what we're looking at. That was my story. As a food innovation entrepreneur, you must try our healthy and very tasty products. But I'm also curious, what are you doing in your agro business? Share your story.